Crazies, you're in the lab. Lee here, man. Y'all saw that title too as well. We're talking about 8 new Mandela effects that blow your mind, make you question this reality we live in currently in this time of day. Yes, 8 new Mandela effects to do what we do. But before we get this going, remember that some of these Mandela effects might not be new to you, but they will be new to somebody else, so please respect that. With that also said, y'all remember to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, and leave me your comments down below about your Mandela effects and these as well. So with further ado, let's get this going. Number 8 for today, we're actually going to the world map and we're going to be talking about South Africa. Yes, South Africa and its location. As you see right here, I have the old map of the old location of where Mr. South Africa was and where it should still be. But as you know, in this reality, South Africa is so much closer to Africa now. Yes, 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 that is correct. South Africa is no longer underneath the United States or Florida. It is slid over to the side, this little shimmy over there closer to original Africa. This is weird. This is odd. I haven't done this one yet on my channel, and I know this one is kind of an old one, but yet, what do you think and what do you believe on this one, and how do you remember South Africa? Do you always remember it being underneath the United States of America? Or do you remember it the way it is now, being just little skirts off of freaking Florida, so much closer to Africa?
Helps keep them extra crunchy and delicious. It's part of your...
That's right, you're great! And we're talking about Tony the Tiger and his wonderful, wonderful nose. Yes, yes, yes. Look at this picture right here. Does Tony the Tiger look normal to you? He doesn't look normal to me neither. As you saw in the commercial and there on the picture, he has a blue nose. Yes, it's a blue nose on the Tony the Tiger now. Yes, yes, yes. In my reality, my past reality, or this reality I live in, or I remember Tony the Tiger having a black nose. Yes, yes, as you see right there, a black nose. The original drawing of Tony the Tiger has a black nose. But as you see, even on the original drawing of Tony the Tiger, he still has a blue nose too as well. I went through this, there's so many pictures of these things, and Mr. Tony the Tiger himself with his nose in different ways and different shapes and forms, but I always remember Tony the Tiger's nose being black. But how do you remember Tony Tiger's nose being? Do you remember it always being blue the way it is now and always has been? Or are you like me and many others, remembering it being black? That is right. Number 6, we're going to be talking about Cuba. And as I was looking this up and I was actually doing this part right here, I flipped over to the buoy in Key West. Now, the Mandela effect is that Cuba is so much closer to the Florida Keys than it's ever been. In my reality, I always remember Cuba being 100 miles from the Key West. There's a buoy that used to say 100 miles. But like I said, as I was doing this and doing the research, it is 90 miles away from Cuba. Key West, Cuba, 90 miles. 90 miles, some say 88. And as I mentioned this buoy, I'm thinking about this buoy. I've seen this buoy 1,000 times. And it now says 90 miles from Cuba, which is odd to me. I always remember that buoy and Cuba being from the Key West to Cuba, 100 miles away. This hurts my feelings. I don't know if this is just my Mandela effect itself, because I live in Florida. I know this damn buoy. It's an iconic buoy. And now it says 90 miles away from Cuba. Cuba's 90 miles away from the Keys. Is it me? Is it reality? Is it the Mandela effect? How do you remember Cuba? Do you remember Cuba being 100 miles away? Or do you remember it the way it is now? And apparently I'd never known it, because to me, that's just odd to me, because I've seen this buoy and it is now 90 miles away.
Jimmy, right? This is your house?
That is correct. Number 5, we're going to be talking about good old Pulp Fiction and Mr. Wolf and his license plate. Big shout out to freaking Recall Victor, man, for this, for showing this and finding this, man. Shout out to you, brother. I had to take it a little bit, throw it on my side, do my little bit, but you understand. And man, and we're talking about the license plate. Yes, the license plate of Mr. Wolf. Take a look at this. Does this look right to you? Is this how you remember this scene? Him pulling up and that license plate saying... 3 something dump 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 dump. No, that is not how I remember it either. My reality recalls reality, millions of those realities. We remember Mr. Wolf's license plate being personalized. Mr. Wolf, that is correct. You see it there, Mr. Wolf, that's how I remember it. And I was thinking to myself, well, maybe it was on the back of his car. Well, as you see this scene right here, look carefully. Nope. It's not on the back. It is the same numbers you saw that was on the front of the license plate. Blows my mind. Big shout out, big find from Recall. Go check them out. Number five, how do you remember Mr. Wolf? Do you remember his license plate being personalized Mr. Wolf? Or do you remember it the way it is? And it always has been three something dumping, 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 dumping. That is right. Number four is going to be my main man, Michael Jackson. Yes, I saw him in Frankfurt, Germany on August 29th, 1992. Dangerous concert on his birthday. It was one of the best concerts of my entire life, as well as this one actually comes from, maybe it's Mandela. Big shout out to her. I'm a big Michael fan. She didn't get me back on that message, but I'm a big Michael fan. I love Michael. And it has to do with the way you make me feel and the chorus of this. You really turned me on. That part right there. Well, listen. You're really turning me on. That is right. That is what you heard right there. You're really turning me on. Now, the lyrics of this song says, you really turned me on. Even the back part of it, the repeat of that says, you really turn me on. And that's how I remember this song. I am a Michael fan. I used to dance in my damn drawers and my socks when I was a little kid. Man, I was on my mom's shoulder at the concert at 12 years old. Hey, Michael! But I always remember turn me on, not turning me on. But how do you remember this, Michael Jackson? Do you always remember him saying, you're really turning me on? Or do you remember it like I remember it, and millions of us Michael Jackson fans remember it? You really turned me on. Number three is going to be Independence Day, and actually the scene, the part where Will walks out, trips over to stuff, grabs a newspaper, looks up, hears all the people going around, looks up and sees the spaceship, and his girlfriend, before fiance, comes out with the cup of coffee, and well, look at here. Now you're like me, you're thinking to yourself, there's a sequence in that scene that is missing. And you're right, you're right. She comes out there, asks him if he wants this cup of coffee. She looks up, she drops the coffee. That's how I remember that scene. I remember that scene so much. I watched this fucking video. I'm a freaking Will Smith fan. And that's an iconic part of that scene. I remember her dropping the coffee cup onto the ground and it's and the reason why I remember it and the reason why it was there is because she comes out asking if you want this cup of coffee. And that's a hint that kind of this cup of coffee is about to fucking fall. You don't mention something in a movie if you're not going to pair it off of it. It's just how it works. But how do you remember that scene? Do you remember it the way I remember it and many others remember it, where she drops the coffee cup? Or do you remember it the way it is, the way it always has been? She never even mishandles that coffee cup.
Incredible. One of the worst performances of my career, and they never doubted it for a second.
Number two is going to be my classic movie, good old Ferris Bueller Day Off. Yes, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, wonderful movie, great thing, but this one is a spelling one for you. Look at this right here. Does Ferris Bueller look right? Does Bueller look spelt right to you? If you said yes, well, you're from this reality, you've never seen the change of it. But if you're like me in this reality and many other people, Bueller never had two L's, and yet the E was before the U. Yes, 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 you heard me right. No two L's, E before the U. And if you can't believe me here, here's a little bit of proof right there for you. Yes, Bueller spelled with the B-E-U and with one L. That's how I remember Bueller being spelt. Ferris Bueller, not Ferris Bueller. It is weird to me, Bueller. It's just odd. It makes no sense. Another spelling with this damn Mandela effect blows my mind because they like playing with letters. They like taking them out and adding them in and flipping them around. That's what they did with Caesar. And it blows my mind. But how do you remember Bueller being spelt? Do you remember Bueller being spelt the way you see it right here? It always has been with two L's and with the U and E differently. Or do you remember it? I gotta remember it. And a few of us remember it being spelt with the B-E-U and with the one L. Number one is for all the people. And as you saw, yes, we're going to be talking about John Lennon, Yoko, and the Imagine video. Yes, Imagine is a classic song. It's a classic video, and it has changed now. Here, take a look. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. Do you see something off there? Do you remember it like I remember it? John being in complete white, that was why it was all white. Yes, they were both supposed to be wearing white, right? But he is now wearing this black space jacket. I don't know where this jacket has come from. It looks totally fucking weird to me. And if I'm getting it wrong, blow my mind up, blow the comments up. But here's a little evidence of John, or of that parody of the white suit. Because some mob got mad.
Imagine. Right, our sparse white living room looks like the John Lennon Yoko Ono Imagine living room. We can't afford Imagine, so just imagine this is Imagine.
Family Guy, remember that. That guy from the YouTube, he remembers the white suit. So you're telling me that our reality is wrong? He never were all white. They weren't on all white. He was wearing a black complete suit and Oko is in the white. It blows my mind because I remember the white suit. I remember that whole video. It was just all white. That's what exactly what it was about. It was just white. So you can imagine just the beauty and the love of all the people. And it's just what it is. But how do you remember this video? How do you remember John Lennon? Do you always remember John Lennon being in that black space jacket? Or do you remember it like many of us remember it, being in complete white suit? There you go. 8 new more Mandela effects there for you to blow your mind. Big shout out to Reality Victor. Big shout out to Maybe It's Mandela. Their links are down below, man. Show them some love. I love the fact that they found this. And sometimes, you know, you just gotta come take it in. I don't take responsibility for this. They did that. But I can bring it in and put in my own little twist on it, because that's what I do sometimes. I like my own twist. But if you did enjoy this at any time, y'all remember to go hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, and leave me those comments down below so we can talk about more of this crazy world we live in. Till then, man, y'all keep your mind open, because those eyes will see everything in front of you. Y'all stay crazy.
I'm going to hang up this phone, and then I'm going to show these people what you don't want them to see. I'm going to show them a world without you. A world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries. A world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice I leave to you.